Speaking of football, here's Deirdre on the KCRA3 patio with today's Workout Wednesday, getting ready to hit the gridiron.
We are. Doesn't it feel like football weather out here, at least in the morning? Afternoon's not so much, but right now it's got that crispiness to the air. And as we start watching football tonight, I think a lot of people, Eric, start thinking about, I think I want to head back out there and play maybe a little bit on the weekends. Eric Pacino's here from Cal Fit. You've got three things that we can do, whether you're a high school player, younger, that will really just get you in shape, get you ready.
Yes, anywhere from the peewee level, where the youth levels are, all the way up to the NFL, all these athletes can really work on these that'll boost their agility. Something that every football player needs at any skill level.
All right, first one is?
So we got pro agility coming up. Jesse's going to be doing a little pro agility here. This is an NFL combine test that tests for speed, moving, and change of direction. So he's working on both sides right now. It's a 5-yard sprint to one side, coming all the way through for 10 yards, changing direction, and going back to the midline.
I love this because you set this up in the backyard.
Yeah, just easy. Two cones, all you need, or you don't even need cones. You just need two little markers that you can hit visually and mentally.
All right, number two.
So Jesse's going to finish up here. Number two is going to be reaction time. What he's going to do here, so he's going to start about 6 to 7 yards out. Coach is going to stand here with a ball up in the air, and all he's going to do is going to drop it. And the objective is to try and beat the ball down before the second bounce.
I do this with my dog.
Do you?
Yeah, different reasons,
now
of course. Yeah.
So,
think about that, Jesse.
All right, you ready? And go. Good. So the objective is to try and get the ball before the second bounce. It really focuses on that power out of the acceleration stance. And that's going to really boost that change of direction from the side going into the opposite direction.
Makes sense. All right, number three.
And then the last and final one that we're going to show today is resisted shuffles. And these works out of the power from the far stance here that you're going to see. So basically, coach will hold the resistance band, and he'll just shuffle side to side. And what this does, it puts resistance on that back leg here to push out with more resistance coming from the side. Then he's going to switch sides. So you get both sides here. And what happens is when you come back, the resistance band wants to pull you back. But you got to fight with that back leg still in order to push and hold yourself up sturdy.
So with all three of these exercises, what's the number one thing that if you do it incorrectly, you will hurt yourself?
The body actually naturally gets in the right position if you have everything set up. So right now his back's straight, his head's looking forward. Okay, it's not on a swivel right now. It's not bent over. And his body's in a squatted position. So you're getting a lot of the power from the hips, the legs, and the core. Go ahead, switch sides. So right now, if you look at his body position, his butt's back, over the heels, knees aren't super over the toes at this point, and he's moving his arms.
All right, thank you very much. Those are three relatively easy ones and three that you can actually do at home today. Appreciate it. You can see this segment and other Workout Wednesday segments just by going to the new KCRA.com. And we'll be back with more right after this.